Hello there! In this video we're gonna tell you about settlement of Colobopsis truncatus ants into the wooden nest medium formicarium. There are two test tubes in the formicarium set. First one is for autonomic humidify and the second one is to be a drinking bowl. The nest of the formicarium is made from a cut of the tree trunk. The diameter is 90 mm and 10 mm thick. We should fill the test tubes with boiled or bottled water, otherwise the water will go moldy and this will affect our ants badly. Test tube sponges, while first time contacting with water, soak up it very slow and therefore we'll put them into water right now. The humidity level is maintained by installing the nest on a gypsum substrate, which in turn is associated with autonomic humidify. For autonomic humidify there is test tube with outside diameter 14 mm and length 120 mm. The 13 ml test tube volume allows to achieve an autonomic maintenance of humidity level within 6-7 days. A drinking bowl is an integral part of our formicariums. For ease of use, it's horizontally located and made of 16 mm diameter and 150 mm length test tube. Formicarium with a wooden nest is designed to contain ants of the genus Camponatus. Overall volume of sections is 10 cubic centimeters. Maximum number of a colony with the average size 3 mm, about 750 pieces. At average size 8 mm, about 70 pieces. While first time installing the test tube for autonomic humidify, you can see how quick a gypsum substrate soaks up water. But soon a gypsum substrate will reach a certain level and will soak up water gradually. As soil, we decided to use marble grains. These ants are small sized. Work ants are about 4-5 mm, soldiers are about 7-8 mm, and therefore a light colored bottom would be preferable. The installation of the nest must ensure a contact of a tree with gypsum substrate, otherwise nest humidification won't be effective. For outworld decoration we've chosen two artificial bushes and a little bit of sea ground. Soon we'll add to the outworld a small branch of a tree, so our carpenter ants will have a chance to climb. And here they are. Up to this day, those ants have been living in the incubator module nest. And as you can see, the water behind the carton has finished and the carton has grown moldy. And therefore, resettlement for this colony is very necessary at the moment. We need to unplug test tube from the incubator and put it to the arena. To feed our pets with sugar syrup, we need to lay down a small plate. As you can see, while we were decorating the outworld, the gypsum substrate has absorbed into itself one test tube of water, and we need to fill it once more. The next day, our family moved in the new nest and located in the farthest from humidification cameras. Because these ants prefer low humidity level, about 50-80%. For easy use, a tree branch we put after an empty test tube has been removed. That's it, my friends. Bye!